हेलो दोस्तों, होप एवरीवन इज गुड। नाउ दैट द प्रीलिम्स इज ओनली 40 50 डेज अहेड, इट इज वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट दैट यू फोकस ऑन द रिवीजन पार्ट, राइट? एटलीस्ट सी टू दैट सी टू इट दैट यू विल बी फोकस यू विल बी गिविंग 30 डेज फॉर द रिवीजन एंड यू विल बी डूइंग एटलीस्ट 2 to 3 टाइम्स ऑफ रिवीजन। सो टुडे वी बॉट मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट करंट अफेयर्स फॉर यूपीएससी प्रीलिम्स 2020। सो दिस कोर्स विल बी एडिंग यू इन द रिवीजन पार्ट। हाउ? लेट अस सी। So we'll bring you the most focus areas of UPSC prelims. For example, if you see the UPSC prelims past papers, there are certain areas in which the UPSC tend to ask questions. For example, any multilateral institution or new fields of science and technology. In this course, we'll be providing will be like a guide for your revision. How? Like for example, if you take the multilateral institutions, we'll be telling you what exactly you need to focus on. Right? Like for example, who are its members? Are there any important conventions? How is the voting power, etc. So while you are going to for revision again, you'll be focusing on these areas. Apart from that, we'll be dealing with the MCQs in the UPSC format. So we will be seeing this while going ahead. And the most important thing of this course is like we'll be providing take terms. Like UPSC has that like certain strategy of preparing the options that I have given, right? So how you have to solve those? Like we will be providing you certain tick terms that might be helping you, right? In this same. So what we will do dealing with it today? So we will be seeing the multilateral institutions, that is a new development bank, and important reports and indices. Here today we'll be dealing with the emission gap report, world press index, and the new areas of science and technology, that is quantum computing, right? And these concepts along with the UPSC format questions. Let's see. The first topic is the new development bank. So why is it in current affairs? The recently the fifth annual meeting of the new development bank has taken place by the board of the governors, right? So if you go so for this topic, we have to go through the background and we have to look that. This is related to the BRICS states. So it was established in 2014 in Fortaleza, Brazil. So there is one important declaration here. It is a Fortaleza declaration. What is say? Here they agreed that they will be focusing on the global development for multilateral regional financial institutions. So its headquarters is in Shanghai. And each of its members has only one vote and there is no veto power. See. Previously, the UPSC has asked this question from the multilateral institutions. Already there was one question on the new development bank. So new development bank has been set up by APSC, which is wrong, which is BRICS, and its headquarters is in Shanghai, right? So it's two only. And in 2019, the last year, they have asked about the Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, right? So here they asked you about the members, who is the greatest stakeholder here, and from which regions they have its members. So these are the areas you will be focusing while you are doing the revision. So let us see one model question on the same. So which among the following are true with regarding the new development bank? So it is initially founded by the BRIC countries while South Africa later joined it. The second statement says India is the second highest in terms of shareholding. So let us focus on the first part. It is initially founded by BRIC countries while South Africa later joined it. See, this statement is regarding the how the BRIC countries has been formed. This is not regarding the new development bank, right? So initially the BRIC countries have come together, later the South Africa joined it. So UPSC tend to confuse you giving this fact of the same institution, right? So you have to be careful. And the second is India is second highest in terms of shareholding. So here we need to apply some common sense. See, what does the current affairs part say here? There is only one vote for the one member. What does it mean? For example, if you take any business or enterprise, if a person has equal voting power, means they have the equal shareholding. So that means that this cannot be true, right? So the answer is None. Right? So here, what I've learned about dictum, so UPSC tends to confuse you regarding the fact of the same institution, right? This is the thing. And the second one, the common sense, right? So the second kind of is like we'll be dealing with the emission gap report. So this is given by the UNEP. What is this? What does this exactly do? So this assesses the gap between the projected emissions that is practically happening and what has been agreed in the Paris Agreement, right? That is to limit to 1.5 to 2 degrees centigrade with respect to industrial, right? Industrial period. What does the report say? That we have to cut up to nearly 7 to 7.6% of the emissions, right? To keep at 1.5 degrees centigrade. The top five emitters, obviously India is there, so please focus on this area. And however, India is set to perform more, it is like overperforming, right? So how it is contributing? India has its own NDC as per the Paris Agreement. So here, there we are saying that we will reduce the emission intensity according to our GDP by 30 to 35% according to 2005 level. And next, we'll be having the 40% of our energy production from the non-fossil fuel sources. And third thing is like where we'll be creating the carbon sink, 2.5 to 3 billion tons. The carbon sink here means like we will be doing afforestation by the Green India Mission, so on. So a little bit background of the UNEP is also very much important here. So it's headquarters in Nairobi. What are its other publications? Our Planet, Atlas of Our Changing Environment, Global Environment Outlook, right? So UNEP, apart from this, it hosts other conventions like Convention on Biodiversity Sites, BRS, that is the Basel, Rotterdam, Stockholm, etc. So it also gives the awards, Champions of the Earth, etc. Right, so let us go ahead and see the certain questions on this. So there are, see, the UPSC have already asked certain few previous year questions on this setting, on this kind of reports. For example, the Global Competitiveness Report, this has been asked in 2019, which is given by the World Economic Forum. Similarly, there are other questions regarding the World Economic Outlook. So this is given by the IMF. So this is the important facts. Should be like focusing on these reports. So we one model MCQ for the UPSC prelims 2020. So here, so what is which among the following are true with respect to the UNEP? It publishes the emission gap report. Yes, we have seen that. It confers Champions of the Earth, which is the UN highest environment honor. Right, this is also true. Right, these are more of factual oriented. This is like आपको पता है तो पता है, नहीं तो नहीं, right? So similar MCQs, if you see, there's one index that has come in the news, World Press Freedom Index. Like this is given by whom? There is a by Reporters Without Borders. So who are they? So they are the one form of NGO, which is very much important. Focus on this, which is NGO. What is its objective? The promotion of the freedom of information. So presently, what are they are doing? They're in Syria, training journalists and bloggers, reporting about the war crimes, etc. See, and another important fact about any index here, like whenever you see that kind of index, remember what is India's rank and who is leading in that. So this is very much important, right? So what I have said is like if at all you get any while you're going to revision, if you get any kind of report, you see to that what report its important findings, and who gives that, and little bit background information regarding the same, whether it is an NGO or it's related to United Nations, etc. The reason why I said to focus on whether it is a inter-government organization or NGO is like, see, there's a similar kind of question that was asked in 2016. So this was regarding the Doctors Without, this is a simple question, Doctors Without Borders, often used, is what? It is nothing but an NGO, right? So another favorite area of the UPSC Iskander is the new science and technology areas. For example, recently in the last year they have asked you about the communication thing, like about the VoLTE technology, etc. So today we'll be seeing about the quantum computing. So recently there have been news about the Google that they are saying that they have achieved quantum supremacy. What does that exactly mean? The quantum supremacy is nothing but they use the conventional computers and harness the quantum concepts to solve a problem within 3 minutes, which the supercomputers would take at least 10,000 years, right? So this is like huge achievement in science and technology part. So UPSC might be asking you directly what is the quantum supremacy that is in the recently news, or they go a little bit to the next step and they might be asking you about some quantum concepts that are very much important in the quantum computing part. So here there are two important concepts of the quantum physics. That is the quantum entanglement and quantum superposition. What is quantum entanglement? Quantum entanglement is nothing but the exchange of the quantum information between two particles. So for example, so far we were dealing with electrons, protons. So it's almost like atomic level. So going more deeper, we'll be dealing with the quantum particles, right? So what is significance of this entanglement means? So these two particles are such that any change in one particle would be giving a significant change in other particle. So this sensitivity of changing in one deriving to other is being harnessed in the quantum computing. And the second thing is is about the quantum superposition. So before explaining this, let us see. Let me give one example. If we take a coin in the starting position, we see only the heads and the tails. When you flip it in the intermediate position, if you concentrate, you see that there's an overlapping position of heads and tails simultaneously, like half heads or half tails. So similarly, what happens in conventional computers, generally the information is stored in ones or zeros. So in quantum computing, what happening is they're using this concept where apart from those two positions, there are intermediate position. See, if information is stored in two position, if it takes that kind of information, if you put in three positions, means it takes more and more information. More and more information means it takes less time to calculate, right? So, excuse me. So they use these concepts in the quantum computing and achieve quantum supremacy, right? So don't go much deeper into that. So just understand the conceptual level and how they implemented that. So model MCQ. So the concepts of entanglement and superposition are associated with quantum physics, right? So see, if you see the previous year questions, since 2019 only they asked about the LTE and VoLTE technology, right? And the other question was an augmented reality and virtual reality. So here I will give you one dictum. So these are the para I would say these are this dictum is called as the paradox statements. See, if you see the statements here, first of all, let me read you the statements. In augmented reality, a stimulated environment is created and the physical world is completely shut out. Okay. In virtual reality, images generated from a computer are projected onto real life objects or surroundings. Okay. And the third one is that augmented reality allows individuals to be present in the world and improves the experiences using the camera of a smartphone or a PC. And the fourth statement is virtual reality closes the world and transposes an individual, providing complete immersion experience. Now, let us see these two statements about the virtual reality here. See, what does the second statement say? It is saying that in virtual reality, images generated from the computer are projected onto real life project or surroundings. Here, it is saying complete immersion, and it's saying closes the world. See, if we see here, these two are opposing kind of statements. If one is true, the second has to be wrong, right? So if you see, images generated from the computer project onto real life. So if it is close, if this is true, that if it is closing the world, how can be this possible? So if you either this statement has to be true, this statement has to be true. If you go and see the options here, we see that we can eliminate two options, and we can say that only two options are right. Either these two would be right, or these two would be the answer, right? One of these two would be the answer. So now see the word what now see now we apply the etymology dictum, right? What does the virtual mean, which is not in the real, right? So the virtual word here much goes with the statement 4, because it says it closes the world. So it has to be in between these two statements. Now read 1 and 3. In augmented reality, stimulated environment is created and the physical world is completely shut down. Completely shut down. Now again, physical world is completely shut down. Yeah, again it's saying. So if we say this is correct, obviously this has to be wrong, right? So obviously the thing is, we got the answer is 3 and 4. So even if this kind of question has come, so don't panic. Focus on this kind of dictums. Take it slowly and you will be able to solve. So what are the takeaways from today's class? Like, we have seen how the UPSC focus areas, and we brought to you the important focus areas regarding the same. And we have seen the model UPSC questions, how the options have been changed voluntarily by the UPSC or the examiner. And we have seen certain examples of the dictums, and we have practiced some UPSC pattern questions, right? Okay, so we'll be continuing this kind of UPSC classes. So stay healthy, stay safe. Jai Hind. Have a good day.